Hello there and welcome to my channel. I'm Marie. Today I'm going to show you how to crochet this beautiful open shell stitch. I absolutely love to use this stitch for a lot of different projects because it creates a very beautiful lightweight fabric that is great for shawls and scarves and throw blankets and a lot more. You can also use it for tops and dresses and projects like that. So without any further ado, let's get started. For this project, I'm going to use some soft merino wool and I'm using Mayflower London Merino DK Light Worsted Weight yarn. I will also need a 4.5 millimeter crochet hook, a darning needle to weave in the ends, and some scissors to cut my yarn. To begin, I'm going to make a slip knot. So I'm going to form a loop, then place my working yarn behind the loop, grab the yarn through the loop with my hook, and pull tight. And for this pattern, I'm going to need a number of chains that is a multiple of 5 plus 3. So however wide you would like to make your blanket or shawl, you will need a multiple of 5 plus 3. But for this little swatch, I'm just going to chain 23. So yarn over, pull through 23 times. To start the first row, I'm going to skip the first chain from the hook and make a single crochet here into the second chain from the hook. So I will insert, pull up a loop, yarn over and pull through 2. And I will just go ahead and make a single crochet into every chain across the row. Insert, pull up a loop, yarn over, pull through 2. All the way across the row. So that is row 1 complete. So to start row 2, I'm going to chain 3. 1, 2, and 3. And I will turn my work. And the 3 chains here will count as the first double crochet of the row. So next, I'm going to skip the next 3 stitches. And I will make a double crochet here into the 4th stitch. So to make a double crochet, I'm going to yarn over, insert, pull up a loop, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, pull through 2. And I will make 2 more double crochet into that same stitch. So 1 and 2 double crochet. Next, I'm going to chain 2. So 1 and 2 chains, and then make 3 more double crochet into that same stitch. So we now have 3 double crochet, chain 2, and 3 double crochet into the same stitch. Next, I'm going to skip 4 stitches. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. And here into the 5th stitch, I will again make 3 double crochet, chain 2, and 3 double crochet into the same stitch. One, two, and 3 double crochet, then chain two, and three more, double crochet into the same stitch. And I will just repeat this pattern all the way across the row. So I will alternately skip four stitches and make three double crochet, chain two, and three double crochet into the next stitch. Again, yarn over, skip one, two, three, and four, and into the fifth, make three double crochet, then chain two, and three more, all into the same stitch. And repeat across. And here at the end of the row, I should have three stitches left. So I'm going to skip the next two stitches and make a double crochet here into the very last stitch. And here's my second row complete. So to start row three, I'm going to chain three again. Then turn my work. And again, the chain three counts as the first double crochet of the row. So next, I'm going to skip the next four stitches and into the chain two space here, I will make three double crochet, chain two, and three double crochet. So just like in the previous row, three double crochet, then chain two, and three more into the same chain space. So I will only be working into the chain spaces of this row. So next, I'm going to skip the next six stitches and work three double crochet, chain two, and three double crochet into the chain two space here. And I will just repeat all the way across the row. So into every chain two space, I will make three double crochet, chain two, and three double crochet. So here at the end of the row, I will have four stitches left, three double crochet, and a chain three that counts as a stitch. So I'm going to skip the next three stitches here and make a double crochet into the top of the chain three. And again, I will chain three and turn my work. And from here, you can just go on and repeat row three until you've reached the desired length of your work. I am now at the end of row 9, and as you can see, my edge here is quite wavy, whereas the other one is very straight. So if you would like to have a straight edge on both sides, I'm just going to show you how you can do that. So first I'm going to chain 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And the 5 chains counts as a double crochet and a chain 3. So I'm going to turn my work and I'm going to skip the first 3 stitches and make a single crochet into the chain 2 space here. Then I'm going to chain 4. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Then I will skip the next 6 stitches and make a single crochet into the chain 2 space. And I will just repeat that all the way across the row. So chain 4, single crochet into the chain 2 space. And here at last, I'm going to chain 3. And I will make a double crochet into the chain 3 here from the previous row. Then I'm going to chain 1 and turn my work. And next I'm going to make 3 single crochet into this first chain space. 1, 2, and 3. Then I will make 4 single crochet into the next chain space. And again, 4 single crochet into every chain 4 space. And I've reached the last chain space, so I'm just going to make 3 single crochet into this last space. And I'm going to fasten off my yarn at this point. And by the way, if you really like this wavy edge here and you would like to have a wavy edge on your scarf or your shawl, you can just make 2 pieces and sew them together in the middle here. So you will have a nice wavy edge on both sides. So now I'm just going to weave in the yarn tails on the back side. And that is it. We are all done. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial and found it useful. If you did, make sure to give it a like, subscribe to my channel, and comment down below if you have any suggestions for my next video. I hope to see you next time. Have a great day. Bye-bye.